Well, today I'm going to be working on this old Waltham Key Wind pocket watch. It's a model 1877. It was made in 1881. I picked it up on eBay and they said it had a broken balance staff. Well, when I started taking it apart, there was a lot more to it than that. So I'm going to go through right now and just replace the balance staff. And then later on, I'll make another video on some of the issues that I had with it. So let's go ahead and take this thing apart and take this old balance staff off of the balance and get a new one put on it. Well, first thing I noticed when I took the balance bridge off, somebody had put a little piece of watch paper underneath the balance bridge. Well, that wasn't a good sign. Kind of looks like a little Band-Aid. Well, here's a piece of the broken staff stuck to the balance bridge. Well, first thing we have to do is take that hairspring off. These are a set of hand removers that I modified. I just took a file and filed them down real thin, and I use these to take the hairspring off. I like using these instead of the screwdriver method. I just slip them underneath the collet of the hairspring and pry them up a little bit, and it pops the hairspring right off that balance. Well, now we got our hairspring loose. Now we can just take it and set that aside and get ready for the next part. Well, now we got my favorite tool out, the staking tool set. So what I'm doing, I'm centering up my hole for my stump that I'm going to be using. The next part I'm going to take off is the roller table. So I center it up and I choose my stump, set it in there and get it lined up. Now here's the punch I'll be using to remove the roller table. Now you notice this punch has a hole in it. It's a cross hole, goes all the way through it, and I believe that's to clean out any of the pivot. If it gets stuck up in there, you'll be able to help clean it out. Now the stump I'm using is a special stump. It has a slot in one of the jaws of the stump, and that slot is to protect the roller jewel in case it sticks out the back of the roller table and it won't break it off. Okay, we're going to get ready now and remove our roller table. Just a few light taps, and it's usually all it takes, and it popped right off. Now we just take our roller table, put it in our little parts tray, and get ready for the next part. Then that's going to be removing the balance staff from this balance. Well, so far this is going pretty good. If you guys have any different techniques the way you do things like this, how about leaving them in the comments section? I sure would like to hear from you. So now we're going to just center up another hole that we're going to use to punch our old staff out of our balance. Now to remove that balance staff, I'm going to be using this special tool here, a balance staff removal tool. Now to set up this tool, you just place the tool over the end of the balance staff on top of the balance and hold the tool with your fingers and turn the top part counterclockwise until the tool is tight against the die plate and the neck of the staking tool frame. Now the tool comes with its own special punch that you use for this tool. Well, now we got everything set up. It's nice and tight. Now we just take our little brass hammer and a few light taps on that punch, and that's usually all it takes to remove that balance staff. Now I'm going to take that tool off and inspect my work and see if everything worked out good with taking that balance staff out. Just unscrew it, slide it out of the way, and there it is. Looks like everything worked out good. Well, here's our balance without the old balance staff and ready for our new balance staff. Made a drawing of what we're going to be doing, and we're going to take, this is the die plate of our staking tool. We're going to take our new staff and we're going to find a hole and set that staff inside that hole. we're going to set our balance on top of that staff, and then we're going to take the round ended hole punch and slide it over that staff, and we're going to hammer down on that punch, and it's going to spread these rivets that are on the end of the new staff. Now that punch has a hole in the center of it, so the staff will go through it. So as we punch down on it, these rivets that are on the side of our new balance staff will spread out in the hole that's in the balance. And that's what rivets it together. Now we got our new staff and we found the correct hole that it fits in. Not too tight and not too loose. It's just the right size hole for it to set in. Now we take our balance and set it over our new staff. Now before I rivet the balance to the staff, I have to make sure the balance is pushed all the way down on top of the staff. I use this flat faced punch with a hole that's bigger than the staff itself. That way I know the punch will just slide over the staff and not touch it, and it'll just rest on the arms of the balance. And then I just lightly tap it a few times and it pushes that balance down on top of the staff and makes it flush. And that way I can start the riveting process. Because if your balance isn't seated onto the staff, your rivet will be loose when you go to try to rivet it, and it won't be tight, and you'll have to start all over again with a brand new staff because you've already tried to rivet the old staff that you're using and you've destroyed it. So you have to start all over again. Now we're going to take our round nose punch, just like I showed in that drawing, and we're going to slide it into our staking tool set and put it onto our balance where it's just touching the balance arm, and we're going to lightly tap it down about three or four times, spinning it around a little bit. And it doesn't take much, you just a few taps. And then we're going to check our work. Now we're going to take our flat nose punch, and what that's going to do is finish up the riveting process, and it's going to make it flat. So the hairspring, when the hairspring sets on top of it, it'll set flat against the balance arm. So what that tool does there, it just flattens the rivet down even further down than the round nose punch did. So the flat punch is flattening out the rivet. Well, now that's all done, it's time to inspect our work and see if everything turned out good. Looks like the rivet is flattened down good, so the hairspring will set good and flush. And I like to put the balance in a pin vise and give it a little twist, not real hard, just enough to see if everything's good and tight, and looks like everything is. So next we're going to go on to the final step, and that's to be putting it all back together. We're going to find us a nice flat stump that'll support those arms of the balance so we don't bend those, and then we're going to put our roller table back on. Get it situated. Now we're going to be using this special punch to put our roller table on. It has a cutout, so the roller jewel will go in that cutout so it won't damage the roller jewel as we push down on it. It gives it clearance. It just takes a few light taps and it's seated down pretty solid. Well, now we're almost done. Now we're going to put our hairspring on, and we use a special stump for that too. So we set our, it has a cutout in it, so our roller jewel sets right in that cutout to protect it. And we just take our hairspring and set it on top of our balance, line it up. Now, if you like these videos with staking tools and watch repairs, subscribe to my channel and also hit that like button. Now to put the hairspring on, I'm using a tapered mouth punch, and it fits right over the collet of the hairspring. That's the gold shiny part, and it just fits right over it. And you just barely push it down. I don't even tap it down. I just push down with my hand. Just use a little hand pressure, and that usually pushes the hairspring collet down. So everything looks good and tight. I'm happy with the way it turned out. I can't wait to get the watch all apart and start cleaning it. And that'll be for another video though.